Hey guys, and welcome to this week's Kids at the Library program. So thank you guys for being so patient, first of all, for not having programs last week. It was great for me to be able to have a little bit of time to put these together for you. So we are back in our bookworm bag. So this month's theme is going to be nature. April has Earth Day in it. As you guys have probably noticed, a lot of the things are waking up because it's finally spring. So I thought we would have a nature-themed bookworm bag. So inside of your kit, you will find a library book checked out to you. So make sure that you bring it back once you're all done reading it. You guys will find some snacks. You guys are gonna find a prize. You guys are also going to find a nature-themed craft activity, which is what I'm gonna talk to you about right now. So in your kit for this activity, it is a DIY sun catcher. So you guys are gonna have some contact paper, which is this stuff here. It looks kind of weird, but we're gonna use that. And then the other thing that you guys are going to find that's in there is this. This is an embroidery hoop. You use it for embroidery. Today we're going to be using it for making a sun catcher. So the nice thing about this is that this is actually two pieces. I'm unscrewing this piece so that I can show you. This is two pieces. This one with the screw on it is the outer ring. This one is the inner ring. That's going to be important. So the first thing that you guys are going to do for this activity is you guys are going to go for a walk. You guys are going to go either out in your garden if you have a garden, you guys can go to the park, you guys can go for a hike if the weather is nice enough. Just go ahead and go out, and I would like you guys to gather some leaves or some flowers, anything that you guys can dry and press flat. So make sure that you guys are picking things that belong to you or are safe to pick, nothing poisonous, and make sure you guys aren't going into, you know, other people's yards. If you guys are out on a hike, make sure that you guys are not disturbing areas that maybe are protected by the Park Service. There are always signs around for that. So it might be nice just to go for, you know, a backyard excursion for this. So once you guys get your flowers or your leaves, your grasses, whatever you guys want to use, you guys are going to take those home. You guys are going to put them in like a paper towel, just a dry paper towel. And then I want you guys to put those in a really heavy book. And you guys are going to close them up in the book. You're going to leave them in there for a little bit, maybe like a week or so, to let them dry out. The drier these are, the longer your sun catcher is going to last, because if they are, you know, still full of light, still very much alive, full of water, eventually they're gonna start to mess with the contact paper. They might even mold, which isn't the end of the world. You could just make a new sun catcher, but if you want the one that you make today to last, make sure that those plant pieces are dry. So let's fast forward in time a little bit. It's now a week since you've gathered your materials, and it is time to put them in your sun catcher. So the first thing that you guys are going to do is you guys are going to take your contact paper. Most of the kits just have one big piece of paper. A couple of them have two pieces. So if you have two pieces of contact paper, you guys can skip this step. Everybody else, we are going to cut this in half. So we're just going to fold it in half, and this is nice because it has little lines on it. You're just going to fold it in half, cut it, and then you're going to have two pieces. So the first piece that you guys are going to use, just go ahead and arrange your pieces of foliage on it. It can be whatever design you want. It doesn't even have to be a design if you don't want to. It can just be kind of, you know, artistically placed pieces of plant, and that is going to be what's going to be showing up in our sun catcher. So once you guys have that stuck down, and you want to make sure that's on the sticky side, so you're going to actually remove this lined piece, then you're going to take your second piece of contact paper and you're going to put it directly over the top. So this is going to be a step that you're going to have to be kind of careful. It's not the end of the world if it's not perfectly lined up, because we're going to cut off the edges, but just to let you know, try to make it as even as possible, because it's going to make it a little bit easier on you. Okay, so sticky side up for putting down your leaves and foliage. On your second piece, sticky side down so that the sticky parts fit together. We do not want any exposed stickiness on this sun catcher. So just so you guys know. All right, so you guys have your beautiful leaves and flowers and stuff trapped inside of your contact paper. Next thing you're gonna do is you're going to put your inner ring, just put it around your design. So if you guys wanted to line up this first on the contact paper so you guys have an idea of how much space you have, that might be a good idea. So once you have your contact paper pushed into your middle ring, or inner ring, you're gonna put this one over top of it. So it's going to seal your contact paper in between the two, okay? And so then once you have that done, you can go ahead and tighten the ring with the screw so it's nice and tight, it's not gonna slip anywhere. And then once your beautiful plants are on display, your ring is all tightened up, you guys are probably gonna have some extra contact paper hanging out of the outside of your embroidery hoop. Just go ahead, take some scissors, cut that off, and you are good to go. You can tie some string onto the hook if you want to hang it from somewhere. If you guys just want to like rest it against a window, that's totally fine too. But that is going to be how we make our DIY sun catcher. There are also instructions in the kit, but I just kind of wanted to give you a visual image of how the things are gonna go together, how to take things apart. But yeah, just make sure that you take time to dry out the plant pieces that you guys gather. That way you can keep your beautiful sun catcher for a little bit longer. Okay, you guys, well, I hope that you enjoy this week's nature-themed bookworm bag. Enjoy the books, make sure you return them once you're all done, and everything else is yours to keep. All right, you guys, I will see you guys next week for our activities on bats. All right, you guys, take care. I'll see you then.